Boker Tov, Chavrim. I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. President Putin and Prime Minister Netanyahu met in Russia just yesterday, dealing with the security issues there in the Golan. The president was informed by Prime Minister Netanyahu that it was extremely important, the Golan. He said that they would never allow the Golan to go back in to Syrian control, that it was a red line for him of sorts. And they worked very close together. Prime Minister Netanyahu saying the meeting was a success. He spent 2 hours in the meeting with President Putin here, and then President Putin advising him that he should have his generals meet with the Foreign Minister Shoigu of Russia. They did do that. They worked out strategies there to be able to work together to allow Israel's Air Force, et cetera, to move freely within the Golan there while there is a war raging across their border. Anyway, we'll just have to kind of see what happens in light of this. President Putin, you know, watching carefully, but at the same time, I do have some reservations. Prime Minister Netanyahu, it's good that he might remember, as much as we see that Putin has been thrown under the bus by the West, Putin still has, and the reason he is in Syria is because of the national interest that he has over the oil that he has signed with Bashar al-Assad. He's also signed one with Mahmoud Abbas. This is one of the main purposes that Israel, there is concerns there. But there again, in his mind, the West Bank is not Israel. He also has recognized the Palestinians as a second state, which could jeopardize the situation and make it quite tense in those regards there. Syria, though, is still part, or the Golan is still technically part of Syria. So I'm just kind of curious, what is he thinking in those lines there as far as Vladimir Putin? Just don't really know the answer to that. Danny Dannon also sending a letter to Ban Ki-moon of the United Nations asking why doesn't he condemn the terrorist attacks of Hamas, the bombing of the bus, planning of the bomb in the bus there, which, by the way, I do want to correct that. We'd put in our title, it may be a suicide bomber when it first happened. We were not sure at that time there. Ended up being that it was a bomb planted on the bus, exploded with no one in the bus. But of course, people that were right near the bus, 16 of them were very seriously wounded from the blast. I don't know if anyone actually died from that blast as of yet. There was one girl that was very seriously injured in that particular attack. Also, a terror tunnel that has been built from Gaza right into the Israeli border there that was discovered by the Israeli armed forces there. Also asking, why are you not condemning these things that are done to Israel? Because the UN is silent on this. Let Israel react to something that the Palestinians have done. And of course, the United Nations will be all over them for those issues there. Also, latest earthquake is happening this morning in Japan. That's right, over in Kumamoto, there was another 4.5 earthquake taking place in Japan, sending people to shelters, 90,000 going to shelters. Several people actually died, not so much from the earthquake, but the after effects and stuff. This is considered an aftershock there, but in the Ring of Fire, as it is called here, that goes around the Pacific Ocean, that follows down the San Andreas Faults, etc., and it goes around to the Japan, and then, of course, out into the islands just north of Australia there. There has been a lot of activity here in the last day. The yellow dots are the last day earthquakes there. The one right here that's in blue, this was the one that, as far as with Japan, this... Let me pull you over to that one there. That's the one that had just gone off here. There was one right in here in Japan that had went off. Now I've done lost it with what I did there. But anyway, but then we've had another earthquake in Ecuador. Another earthquake. Now this one here is an actual earthquake that has taken place in Ecuador. Let me try to pull this up for you here. It is a 6.0 earthquake that took place right here in Ecuador. Very volatile situation. You know, they just had the 7.8 earthquake. RT News has already reported on this earthquake here. 6.0 quake strikes Ecuador amid recovery efforts. This is, of course, you can see this isn't, you would think you're looking at Syria right here when you see this photograph here in Ecuador. It looks like Syria being bombed out, but it's been bombed out all right, but it's bombed out by earthquakes. 7.8 earthquake that shook this building here to the ground. And now, yet again, right off the coast of Ecuador, a 6.0 earthquake has taken place there. And it's already been, 580 victims to the 7.8 earthquake, and now a 6.0 earthquake is rattling this this region of the world. Do pray for these people. Very serious situation indeed that is going on there, as well as the people in Japan. Japan has suffered major earthquakes in the past, also with Fukushima, and all the radiation that's not being told. Jesse with BP Earthwatch brought out a very good broadcast on that about Fukushima and the radiation levels that are not being told to the public there. It's very much under wraps, being kept quiet. It concerns me because I do have two sisters and a brother that live in Japan, and I have sent them messages that, you know, to let them know this is a very serious situation in the country there. They should leave. Of course not. They should evacuate really all of Japan due to the radiation levels there, but it'll never be done. It's just like America when it comes to the massive earthquake that will strike the United States eventually, that will send tidal waves, massive tidal waves over Florida and over the West Coast. They're not going to evacuate. They're going to let the people just fall victim to it. Maybe it's part of the depopulation program. Who knows? Anyway, I'm Stephen Bannoun. I'm hoping tonight will be the night of the special broadcast regarding the story of Joseph. Very fascinating, new insights might just rattle the Jewish people in recognizing who their Messiah is. Now, it's not part of what the two witnesses will do, but I guarantee you one thing, it is a message that might just rattle some thinking there to make them stop and look. We have missed our Messiah. What is going on? I'm Stephen Bannoun with Israeli News Live. Shalom.